Britain's rail network is a marvel of engineering. Travel by train is quick, efficient, environmentally friendly, and reliable. At Network Rail, we manage the rail infrastructure by using cutting-edge technology and employing exacting safety standards. Rail is the safest form of transport in Britain, and we're continually trying to make it even safer. This film looks at one of the biggest challenges we face in keeping the network safe. Level crossings. Years ago, when the rail network was being built, rail engineers couldn't afford to build bridges or tunnels at every point the rails crossed a road. So instead, they created level crossings, places which allowed vehicles, pedestrians, and animals to cross over railway lines. We now have around 7,000 level crossings in the UK. Most of them are private crossings or footpaths, but about 1 in 5 are on public roads. Level crossings come in all shapes and sizes, from a walkway over the railway, to crossings that need a telephone to get permission to cross, to busy town centre crossings, with thousands of cars and pedestrians passing through each day. The traditional form of road crossing on British railways consisted of hinged gates. These prevented road traffic from crossing when closed and stopped animals escaping from the road to the railway. Many still exist today. This one is a staff-operated crossing. The crossing is protected by barriers across both sides of the road. This type of crossing closes the road for typically 2 minutes, as it is necessary to prove the crossing is clear before allowing the signals to clear, and if the crossing isn't clear, to leave enough time to stop the train before it reaches the level crossing. Slow opening and closing mean traffic delays. Many gated crossings have been replaced by lifting barriers, which are easier to mechanise. These can come in different forms. Full barriers consist of barriers each side of the track, which block the entire width of the road. They're used in busy areas where road traffic is high. In order to avoid vehicles being trapped when the barriers go down, these crossings are remotely monitored by signalers using CCTV. At automatic half barrier crossings, the barriers block off each side of the road separately. As a train approaches, it triggers the automated level crossing controllers. An amber light shines and twin red lights flash, warning drivers to halt, and alarm sounds for pedestrians. A short time after the lights come on, the barriers fall on the left-hand side of the road on each side, usually 9 to 12 seconds before the train arrives. Signals tell drivers to keep the crossing clear, and if the lights continue to flash after the train has passed, it means another train is approaching. A phone on both sides of the crossing can be used to contact a signaller in an emergency, or if the driver has a large or slow-moving vehicle that needs to cross.
You're clear to cross, could you give me a ring when you're clear of the other side, please? Thank you very much.
Automated half-barrier crossings keep road traffic delays to a minimum. However, there is no time to stop the train if the crossing is occupied. With automated half-barriers, motorists are less likely to be stranded between barriers and unable to exit. But cases where impatient motorists have driven around the barriers have caused safety concerns. In fact, level crossings as a whole are the biggest safety challenge that we face at Network Rail. In 2010, there were 3,466 recorded incidents of misuse or error. There were 7 collisions between vehicles and trains. And more than 100 near misses, that's over 2 a week. Level crossings are designed to be safe when used correctly. Misuse by pedestrians or motorists leads to extreme danger for themselves, users of the level crossing, and people on the train. We want a safe and reliable railway, so we've a programme in place to reduce level crossing risk across the country. But we need the public to be aware of the need for more responsible behaviour. We hope you can help.